Hello and welcome back to another episode of Hodges Hot Wheels and Diecast. This week we are going to be touching on the spoiler series Redline the Boss Hoss, which is, as you can see, is a beautiful, beautiful car. It's based off a 67-68 Mustang Fastback, which to me is one of the sexiest cars that was ever produced. And it's one of the last ones of the spoiler series that I want to do. Just so happens I have two of them, so I'll do two of them. These are the Super Chrome series, or the Chrome series. I don't know whether they're called Super Chromes or what back then, but the ones that are actually painted are hard as hell to get a hold of. These are a little bit more easy and affordable. But what we're going to do, we're going to take it a next level up. We're going to go ahead and paint these Spectre Flame colors. And most people would probably just shoot it right over the chrome, but then that's going to give you the effect of a modern Redline Club car, which I do not want. So what we're going to do is, once we get these things sorted, I am going to take these and zinc them. But before we do that, we have repairs on both of these roofs. This one is missing, for one thing, is missing the windshield and the whole window. I guess some kid decided he wanted to pull it out, and the roof is bent like hell. And both pillars, well, this one, it'll crack when I straighten it. Both pillars are bent to the side. A little bit funky back here. The same with this one. This one's kind of, these things got took a beating. See, as you can see, the whole side is pushed that way. Now this car has pushed on wheels. This car has capped wheels. So we will be restoring these. This one, since it has cracks up at the top of the post, we will be putting the black vinyl top on this one. And depending on how it goes with this one, maybe this one I will leave a bare roof. And I don't think, yeah, I'm going to have to get two windshields because that one's cracked. So we are going to restore these babies as Spectre Flame colors, and I'll figure out the colors later, and we will re-zinc them over the chrome to make them look more realistic. So stay tuned as we take these babies apart. Okay, here we are back with our two Boss Hosses, and they are fresh out of the vat. nice and clean. You can see this one's a little bit rougher than the other. And the next step I have to do here is address these roofs, especially this one. This one's actually cracked up here. And this one is a wee bit crooked too. So it's going to have to go that way. So now I did some research on these, and they actually had, when they were done with the club cars, they actually took a lot of the club cars that were chrome and painted over right over the chrome with Spectraflame. But unfortunately for this one, I was going to do that and maybe put a black roof on it, because I'm going to have to, I have that crack in the top there, but we have this big old gouge in the chrome there, and it's all, it's chipped in certain spots. So I'm going to go ahead and zinc everything to get that chrome look off of this and make it look like the originals. And depending on this one here, I'll probably, maybe I'll do one with the vinyl top, which I don't know why they put a vinyl top on a fastback, but for originality's sake of the Spectraflame ones, we'll put, do one with it with and one without. So, and this one will definitely, like I say, benefit from a zinc plating, because it's got a lot of chips and stuff, but the body's in good shape. So I noticed something here. Look at that. One has door lines, the other does not. Very, very interesting. Maybe one of my viewers could tell me, because this one had pressed on wheels. This one with door panels had capped wheels. So, Hot Wheels gurus, help me out here. So, stay tuned for more action. Let's get this roof straightened out. Okay, and we are back. We are back with our Boss Hosses. And the roofs have been repaired. I just had one crack right there. But I think it's in the chrome. I can't tell. Maybe let's sand it down a little bit, see what we got. Maybe it is, maybe it didn't. I don't know. But this is the side that was smashed. And it turned out pretty damn good. It might be tweaked just a little bit, but not enough to notice. Especially put that silly vinyl top on it, just for history's sake. I fitted the windows, and I've done a little bit of scuffing on them. Yeah, we probably could have just painted over chrome, just like some of the scabby restorers on eBay would do, but we're going to take it to the next level, just as Hot Wheels would have done. We are going to make these zinc plated along with these, take some of the shine off of them, so you will not notice that they are chromed additions. So stay tuned for more action. Keep an eye on it, Mr. T. Let me know when it's done. Here we are back with our pair of Boss Hosses, fresh out of the zinc. Now, I've done a lot of, this is a lot of zinc plating here. To get rid of the chrome, I I sanded a lot of that off, a lot of stuff off of these to make them look a lot more smooth because they were kind of rough and I don't like that. And like I say, turned out pretty well. The roofs are nice and straight and everything's not chrome anymore. It's the zinc plate just like it's supposed to be. And that's the one. This is the one that was a little bit more rough than the other. And this is the one that had better chrome, but had a bent roof. And it turned out well. Can't really tell. It only has one little tiny crack right there, and it's not going to be noticeable. Barely noticeable. It's a little noticeable. But if I put a black vinyl top like some of these did, you'll never see it. And the zinc plating turned out beautiful. And I zinc plated the bases too to give them a more natural look instead of being chrome, because it just would look totally crazy if I left them in chrome. You could tell that this was a super chrome car. I didn't want you to be able to know that. So, anyways, that's where we are. These are ready for paint. I got to figure out what colors I'm going to paint them. And we'll be back. Stay tuned. Alrighty, here we are back with our Boss Hoss conversions from chrome to zinc. And I got everything back and done on them. We'll start with this one. This one was the one that was the less better of the two. I ended up zincing the bases to get the chrome off of them. And I actually had to do a little work to the front bumper because it had some nicks in, or dents in it from kids probably bouncing it off something. And we did a tune on the axles. They're still a little bit loose. I mean, heck, it is 50 years old, and or 50, maybe 51, 52. But the zinc looks more like the original Zamac and gives the effect. It's not chrome anymore. Because most of the people I see, I mean, they did shoot them over chrome, and yeah, but I wanted to make them as close to the originals Zamac or the Spectraflame ones that weren't chrome, that weren't leftovers from the super chrome cars. This here, I got this windshield glass from Imakuta 24. It's a very nice one. I bought this earlier from Second Chance Red Lines. And as these are nice too, I think they're more of a resin style. These Imakuta 24 ones are way much better. I mean, once you put it in, you can't really tell the difference. I mean, there's some subtle differences, but you know, these are far superior, especially with blue glass. This has got a little bit of blue tint to it, but hey, I got it, so I got to use it. And nice polished engines. So they all look brand new. Gray interior was dusty as hell. We just gave it a wash. And last but not least, this beautiful body. Look at there, done in rose Spectraflame, zinced, and lots of SOS pads and cleaning. And it's about as perfect as you can get for a restored red line, as far as I'm concerned. And absolutely no toning spots, no dark spots, because it is fresh zinc, which is why I zinc everything, and it doesn't look like a chrome car anymore. And here's the beautiful orange one, which is my favorite. And all new decals. The decals are from the Redline shop. They are superior for these original restorations. They stick on just like the originals, but they're way better quality. And I didn't skimp on anything here. I tried to get them as original as possible, being that they are conversions, but I don't think anybody can tell the difference now. So, this looks like a restored car. Turned out beautiful. This one actually is the one that had the white interior, the capped wheels, and the bent roof. As you can see, the bent roof is perfect. And I only had that little tiny crack right there, which I was going to put a vinyl top on this, but who puts a vinyl top on a fastback? Come on. So, and it turned out just as good, so it'll look great. And we put the new capped wheels. This one, the front bumper was a little bit, you can see it's a little bit more crisp, didn't have any dents. And as you can see, it looks like a fresh Z-Mac bottom. And I painted the tail just like the originals. And no more chrome. So, there you have it. Let's put these babies together and get them on the turntable. Okay, here we are back with our reveal for our pair of beautiful Boss Hoss Mustangs from Hot Wheels. There you are, in all their glory. These suckers are too damn expensive to buy zinc plated ones that are beat up. It's easier to buy the chrome ones and shoot chrome over them, or just zinc them like I did and make them your own. I mean, theoretically, nobody's going to tell the difference whether I restored a chrome or a regular Z-Mac one. So, and I think the Z-Mac ones look more true. And we got one here, the capped wheel one that had the busted roof with and done in the Spectre Flame orange, and we have the rose colored one which had pushed on wheels done in Spectre Flame rose. Since I only had, this is only my second rose colored car that I've done. It's like a magenta, but it's a little bit, just a shade different. Now if you remember correctly, the orange one had more pronounced door moldings and this one, or door marks, and this one did not. So that's how I was telling them apart, and I didn't get rid of any of that stuff. It's all still there. And like I say, I'm really proud of these, because this is one of those, you know, these red lines from the early eras of Spectre Flame, people on eBay and other auction sites have just lost their freaking mind selling junk for big bucks. I'm paying $30 and $35 a piece for some of this crap, and luckily I have a fair amount. Some of the people have been nice enough to send me stuff, and but this is where I started, and where it's kind of nice to go back to where you started, because you know I haven't done it in a while. So just a straight up all stock restorations, conversions, whatever you want to call them. I mean, the purists will call them conversions, but it doesn't matter what you think of my restorations. They're my cars. I love them. They're going in my showcase, and they're two awesome examples. Now I did switch the interior, because the darker interior looks better in the orange one. And the white interior looks better in the rose-colored one. So, but there you have it. Sorry I haven't been around. It's hay season right now. I'm 109 bales into a target of 300. And we're getting thunderstorms every day now, so it makes it hard to get a three-day window, because that's what it takes for me to round up bales. And usually this time of year, it's kind of tough. So I'll get out what I can, but not going anywhere. I'm always here. So I hope you've enjoyed this, and have a great weekend.